Here we're going to look at plots of fugacity as a function of temperature and as a function of pressure. So first, let's look at constant pressure. And so the pressure for this figure is 0.90 bar. And so what we see is at low temperatures, the fugacity here is the saturation pressure. This is assuming the gas phase would be ideal. And then at high temperatures, where we have a vapor, the fugacity is just the pressure, which is 0.90 bar. So the transition, of course, is at the saturation temperature. And what the diagram is trying to show is that when the liquid has the lower fugacity, it's the stable phase, namely between here and here. And then when the vapor, the solid line, has the lower fugacity here and then up to higher temperatures, then the vapor is the stable phase. And we're assuming ideal gas, and that's why we set fugacity in the vapor phase equal to the pressure. Fugacity has units of pressure. So we want to look at the corresponding figure for fugacity as a function of pressure, and this is at low pressure, so this is at constant temperature. Same condition as the previous figure. So the saturation pressure in this case is 0.90 bar. In this region, vapor has the lower fugacity, so it's the stable phase. Fugacity just equal to pressure, ideal gas, this is a straight line. Here, fugacity is equal to the saturation pressure. In other words, once we get to saturation pressure, we form a liquid, increasing the pressure, and a liquid has very little effect on fugacity. As we go to high pressures, we can calculate more accurately using the pointing correction factor, but over this range, this is a pretty good approximation. So the thing to keep in mind is the stable phase is the phase with the lower fugacity. In this case, liquid at high pressure, vapor at low pressure. And then we can look at the interactive simulation that was used to make these figures to see how, for example, this figure changes as we change the temperature. So here we're looking at the interactive simulation, and we can change the pressure. So we're looking at one pressure, fugacity versus temperature. If I increase the pressure, then of course it takes a higher temperature before we form a vapor phase, and so that means there's a larger range of temperature where the liquid has the lower fugacity and therefore is the stable phase. The corresponding plot for fugacity versus pressure, so this is at a fixed temperature, and as I increase the temperature, then the saturation pressure increases. We go to a higher pressure before the liquid has the lower fugacity and becomes the stable phase. Well, the other thing that this simulation tries to represent is if we select high pressure, notice we've changed the y-axis scale, and let me get back on scale here. So as I lower the temperature, you'll notice that the vapor plot is not quite a straight line. We're trying to count here for the fact we have a 9 ideal gas, but otherwise the behavior is the same. We have to go to higher temperature. We fix the temperature, we have to go to higher pressure as we raise the temperature before liquid becomes the stable phase of lower fugacity. But the important thing to note here is that the vapor fugacity curve is a curve. It's slightly deviating from a straight line where fugacity is equal to pressure. Instead, fugacity is less than pressure.